Hello, I wish to register a complaint. Hello, miss.
What do you mean, miss?
I'm sorry, I have a cold. I wish to make a complaint.
Sorry, we're closing for lunch.
Never mind that, my lad. I wish to complain about this parrot what I purchased not half an hour ago from this very boutique.
Oh, yes, the Norwegian blue. What's wrong with it?
I'll tell you what's wrong with it. It's dead. That's what's wrong with it.
No, it's resting. Look.
Look, my lad, I know a dead parrot when I see one, and I'm looking at one right now.
No, it's not dead, it's resting.
Resting?
Yeah. Remarkable bird, the Norwegian blue. Beautiful plumage, isn't it?
The plumage don't enter into it. It's stone dead.
No, it's resting.
All right, then. If it's resting, I'll wake it up. Hello, Polly. I got a nice cuttlefish for you when you wake up, Polly Parrot.
There, it moved.
No, it didn't. That was you pushing the gate.
I did not.
Yes, you did. Hello, Polly. Polly. Polly Parrot, wake up. Polly. Now, that's what I call a dead parrot.
No, it's stunned.
Look, my lad, I've had just about enough of this. That parrot is definitely deceased. And when I bought it not half an hour ago, you assured me that its lack of movement was due to it being tired and shagged out after a long squawk.
It's got me pining for the fjords.
Pining for the fjords? What kind of talk is that? Look, where did it fall flat on its back the moment I got it home?
The Norwegian blue prefers kipping on its back. It's a beautiful bird, lovely plumage.
Look, I took the liberty of examining that parrot, and I discovered that the only reason that it had been sitting on its perch in the first place was that it had been nailed there.
Well, of course it was nailed there, otherwise it muscled up to those bars and boom!
Look, matey. This parrot wouldn't boom if I put 4,000 bolts through it. It's bleeding demise.
It's not. It's pining.
It's not pining. It's passed on. This parrot is no more. It has ceased to be. It's expired and gone to meet its maker. This is a late parrot. It's a stiff. Bereft of life, it rests in peace. If you hadn't nailed it to the perch, you would be pushing up the daisies. It's run down the curtain and joined the choir invisible. This is an ex-parrot.
Well, I'd better replace it then.
If you want to get anything done in this country, you've got to complain to your blue in the mouth.
Sorry, Gov, we're right out of parrots.
I see. I get the picture.
I've got a slug.
Does it talk?
Not really, no.
Well, it's scarcely a replacement then, is it?
Listen, I'll tell you what. If you go to my brother's pet shop in Bolton, he'll replace your parrot for you.
Bolton, eh?
Yeah.
All right. Excuse me. This is Bolton, is it?
No, it's Ipswich.
That's Intercity Rail for you. I wish to make complaint.
I don't have to do this, you know.
A bigger pardon?
I'm a qualified brain surgeon. I only do this because I like being my own boss.
Excuse me, this is irrelevant, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, it's not easy to pad these out to 30 minutes.
Well, I wish to make it complete. I got on the Bolton train and found myself deposited here in Ipswich.
No, this is Bolton.
The pet shop owner's brother was lying.
Well, you can't blame British Rail for that.
If this is Bolton, I shall return to the pet shop. That this is Bolton.
Yeah?
Well, you told me it was Ipswich.
It was a pun.
A pun?
No, not a pun. No, what's the other thing which reads the same backwards as forwards?
A palindrome?
Yeah.
It's not a palindrome. The palindrome of Bolton would be not lob. It don't work.
Look, what do you want?
No, I'm sorry. I'm not prepared to pursue my line of inquiry any further, as I think this is getting too silly.
Quite agree. Silly. Right. Get on with it.